Scapy is easy to use. Moreover, we can find many examples over the internet. We sometimes need to resend the captured traffic to a device for alert reproduction. Specifically speaking, I had difficulty reproducing proprietary UDM alerts when I started working as a network security engineer. As time went by, the demands for traffic reproduction increased because new sophisticated traffic monitoring analysis devices and services started working and making issues regarding alerts. Lots of false positives and negatives. I believe there are many automated alerts inspection programs, TP, TN, FP, FN verdict system deployed in the modern environments. So this system might not be useful to you immediately. However, in case you need to investigate a specific raw FP or FN alerts, this simple script might be a quick solution to your problem. There are not so many examples in rewriting or resending raw data PCAP using Scapy. I assume the reason is that we usually don't need to do that. Imagine that you want to generate, say, HTTP traffic a couple of times. How do you do that? A simple shell script with curl commands is enough, right? We don't need to start from PCAP file manipulation. However, in some cases, we have to resend data in PCAP without changing anything, or with slight modifications to investigate the root cause of alerts. Yeah, I know we can do the same with UDPreplay, but for now, let's stick to Python Scapy. This is nice material on learning how to manipulate the packet structure manually. We are writing a piece of code for replaying the UDP traffic. First, we are replaying the PCAP as is, then updating, replaying the values and saving the data to a new PCAP file. The newly generated file should be warning-free on the receiving side. Too easy? If so, you are purchasing the wrong course. Stop here, don't buy. Reading PCAP is very easy, a line of code is enough. Even if you are not familiar with the Python, you'll understand it in a second. Once the PCAP file is loaded, we need to choose which fields of PCAP to rewrite. Recalculation is where we have to deal with relatively arduous tasks. Please try this on your own and find out what's the problem. First, try sending the updated data to the server. The packets should be dropped because of the wrong checksums. Simply delete them if wrong. The checksum and length fields are automatically recalculated by Scapy when packets leave the machine. But what if you want to save the updated data to a PCAP file? How do you do that? First, we are collecting PCAP using NC. There is nothing complicated here. NC with UDP options. I'm sending a message using UDP port 12345 from Ubuntu machine to carry. Please use your favorite machines as long as you can follow the course contents. That's why I didn't explain machine installations. I need only UDP traffic, so I'm exporting the packet. I'm installing Scapy using apt apt. If you don't want to mess up your environment, I think venv or virtualenv might have been an option. Okay, let's call Scapy. I'm showing minimal sets of commands you have to know for PCAP parsing. As I said, reading or loading PCAP is a one-liner. I'll do PCAP and specify the PCAP file name. Now we can get an overview of the loaded packets. Shell will give us a bit of structure detail. Because we want to access the first element of the PCAP file, we have to type 0. Okay, familiar information shows up. it shall give us pretty printed information. Now, I think you can guess how to get to the IP field. Yeah, just add square brackets. Sorry, let me turn off screen key. So let's access the exact value. For example, TTL 64. Oh, nice. How about the protocol number 17? I remember this means UDP, but let me check it out. Yeah, here it is. The message we want to rewrite is on raw. This is everything you need to know about Scapy in this section. Nothing complicated, right? I personally don't want to repeat the same thing each time. So put these commands into a script. Don't forget to add the first line from scapy.all import asterisk. Let's update the payload. Maybe the wording might be confusing. If I say payload, that means the message we've sent. Updating the value is simply putting the new value to the target field. That's it. Please refer to the attached document for the code. Basically the same as the previous one, but the difference is that I've added the sendp function. This is for sending a packet. Please specify iface in sendp function. Although Scapy can automatically assume the SLC interface, it is often wrong. Now I'm replaying the data in PCAP. Well, the packet left the machine but got dropped somewhere in the network. Remember the troubleshooting process. We know we can pin this host, so we can skip the data link and the network layer investigations. There should be something wrong with transap layer. As you know, TCP dump is a CLI packet capture tool. If we cannot find any errors with verbose output, we have to trace the internal packet processing in this machine using IP tables. Nice. I think we are now spotting the problem. Bad UDP checksum. It might look odd because we are sending the same packet. The checksum calculation result should be the same if the data is the same. Anyway, as we are not developers here, the important thing is to know how to fix this problem quickly. Maybe I saved the PCAP in the wrong way. It's rare to have a chance to sniff exactly the same packet in the real world, so we have to get the things done with what we have. TCP dump said that our UDP checksum was wrong, so delete it and make Scapy recalc. Our goal is to update the payload, so it might be safe to delete all the checksum and length fields. For now, try deleting the UDP checksum to see if this works. Okay, great. This is the overall process when reusing PCAP with a modified payload. What you have to understand here is the last portion. A contains all the information other than IP, UDP links, and checksums. I'm lazy and don't want to recalc those values manually, so I decide to let Scapy do the job. A.build returns binary data. If we enclose the data with the ether function, we can obtain a whole new error-free packet B. Before running the code, let me optimize the receiving program. In plain English, I don't want to call NC again and again. Instead, I want something that can listen on port 12345 UDP forever. Here is the ultimate code. Please refer to the attached document for this code. I know, it's dirty. Great, now we've achieved the goal. Oh, I have to mention that this will not work if we want to do TCP replay. That's mainly due to sequence number. Let's solve that problem later together. Thanks for watching. See you in the next section.